Welcome back to another beautiful day, sunny day, I should say, in Florida. It's a early morning, about say 9:15, 9:30 in the morning, so it's not quite hot yet. All right, today I am gonna have a show you another project of mine. So you can see this is a bicycle, but it's not any typical bicycle. As you can see, some of you might have guessed already, this is an electric bike. Okay, and I have the opportunity to bought this off an elderly gentleman, but obviously if you notice, it's missing a battery. Okay, so there's no battery that normally goes here. I looked this bike up. Online, and brand new. They typically go for about, I think maybe the price is $729. It wasn't that rye, and I guess it's been left out in the environment for a little bit. So as you can see, it has a few rusted spot, especially over the, the fort here and all that, and which I clean up pretty well, as best as I can. The only thing left is down here in the hub area. It didn't come out quite well, as it's very much much more rusted. But overall, it's not a bad condition, I have to say. So something to do, I guess, especially now the gasoline price has gone up so much. We gotta seek alternative, I guess. And this is one of those fun hobby that it'll be interesting to do. So anyway, I'm gonna have to search for a battery, because this bike here online, they ran out of the battery, replacement battery, so for it. So I have to probably look for somewhere, maybe Amazon, maybe, to see if they have a compatible. But anyhow, it'll be interesting. All right, so stay tuned. Several days later. So here's the battery for the bike. Okay. I'm gonna try to fit it in. This bike has a lever right here that you just kind of push up and lift up on this thing. Just like that. And beforehand, I guess we're gonna try to fit it. What's going on? So likely it's gonna go on like that, and it will sit right down like that. Okay, so it has some clearance. So even with the bike seat down, I think it's a doable, Alright, so I just have to put the bracket here in and reconfigure the connector on the bottom and see how it goes. Okay. So this is the original connector. You can see there is more toe with the front of the bike, but but this is the new plate. So I suppose it's more toward the center, the battery. So it's not quite. So we have to figure out. Yeah, this battery is a 36 volt 10 amp battery, lithium ion. There's a plate that came with the battery here, so I have to remove the plate and get that installed. So how you remove this plate is you put the keys in there, and then I think you have to turn. Unlocked. Okay, so then there's an unlock. Okay, see that? Yeah, so it's by turning to the unlock position, this pin will release. And that's how you're able to slide this bracket out. So a couple of things we have to do. We have to change out this plastic plate here and put in the new connector that will match that came with this battery, and then install this bracket. So removing the old plate, there's four screw here. Make sure you don't lose this screw, and then okay, and then this plate lift up. But anyhow, so this original connector has to be replaced with the new one. So it just pull out, you can see the positive, black is negative, red is positive. So it just pull out like that. Okay. Either you have to find the right crimp connector like to make up, or you have to unsolder this, I guess, and reuse it. Okay. Okay, so we have a little dilemma here. This original plate, the connector is up here. As you can see, right here, right? Yeah, but so that's not gonna work because the new battery, yeah, it looks like, yeah, if this is the new battery plate, this connector has to be down here at this near the center almost. All right, so anything, I think we have to cut this metal plate that's on the bike, which is not the most ideal, but yeah, so it looks like we gotta cut that. So something that we probably have to consider. Yeah, so this connector is quite beefier. Right. I might end up reusing this connector, so I guess. Yep. So our choice is probably, probably either cut both this holding battery, I guess, right here, and also the underneath, and retrofit that. Yeah. So modify this plastic tray, and also this down here. A little some work, but I think it's doable, and we'll probably reuse this connector. Okay, let's see if we can do that. Okay, so I guess the important thing is, before we do all this modification, is we need to test out this, see if it's compatible, I guess, with the bike. So I guess the first thing we need to do is probably connect it up and see if it will work. So that's the first thing. So So let's connect it up and see if it will be able to. So what I'm doing is I'm gonna use the old connector, okay, that was on here. So put back my battery connector here. Red to red for positive and for negative. Okay. And make sure that it's correctly. So it's labeled in the bottom here for positive and negative. Sure that it goes in the proper way. Alright, and I guess I'm gonna support the bottom here to make sure that it's not being short or anything like that. Okay. Alright, so just like that. You can see that well. Okay. So the bite has lifted it. Oh. So here you go. Okay, so first of all, turn on your, yeah, so make sure power's on. Okay, you can see. Oh, there you go. I do have a light. So this is a power switch for it. I guess, no, it's automatically on the bike. This switch right there. Okay, see the horn works. Okay, it works. Alright, so I guess this button has already been pushed in. So let me see, let me give it a throttle. There's a throttle right here. So, oh, there you go. Yep. Oh, the bite is going. Cool. You can see, yep. Yep, spinning. Let me see if I push this button out. I think that's where the off button is. Oh. So yeah, I'm not sure what that button is for. So maybe for a different low speed and high speed maybe. So let me press it back in. Cool, yeah, alright. So yeah, so that's half the battle. That, you know, make sure that your battery can work with the bike. The next thing is to modify it and put it in. So that's half the battle, I guess. But just the important thing is make sure that the battery is working. And I'm quite happy with that. So okay, so my next thing is to start cutting out the plate and the plastic and make sure it fit it well. Yeah, so what I'm doing is this is the original plate. I'm drilling, I guess, all the way through for this guiding bracket. Yeah, so just because I figure there's a slot here and I don't want to cover that if in case the water or rain, it can get in there and just come right out rather than trap in that pocket. So yeah, like, yeah, so yeah, 'cause you can see the original plate. Yeah, so that's what it is. It's, you know, it's going down to the floor. So maybe that's the best thing. So okay, and then now that's done, I'm gonna probably drill a hole here and put a screw to hold this bracket in place. Yep, and that'll make it strong. All right, and then. And then drill out the hole for the out, you know, then the for the socket, yeah, the electrical. Okay, so I kind of measured this hole and transfer here at the center. Yeah, for basically I measure it to this opening, and then I try to center this hole in the center there. Put some masking tape and I'm gonna try to cut it out. see what happened. It's probably best to get close and probably use some file. File it off is probably better to get that precise opening. Okay. Yeah, once we get the precise opening, then it probably want to bevel a little bit, yeah, for this. Yeah, because we can see it has a little bit bevel to sit it in nicely. So we want to probably do the same thing. Yeah, after we do this. All right. File that is pretty close, probably just need a little bit more, should be good. Okay. Yep. Yep. Seems like it's in there good. Alright, I gotta go. You're gonna go with it. Okay. But overall, this is what it's gonna look like. And this is the tray right here. Not bad. That's how it's gonna look like. Yeah, I might put some electrical tape or something to cover up the original hole, just to keep, you know, water from going down there, because the controller is gonna be sitting underneath the box. Yeah, but overall, that's how, not too bad. I think it worked. All right, so I just have to secure this bracket, and that should be it. All right. It's all finished, so everything's in. There we go. I have to put that to secure that a little bit. There we go. All right. So I guess we're gonna take it for a spin and see what happens. Everything back looking good. Kind of fit well. Yep, overall it's pretty good. All right, let's take it for a ride. Okay, here we go. Okay. Yeah. All right, looking good. Pretty good. It's going pretty fast. Oh yeah, I can like this. It's a lot of fun. It's pretty zippy. Yeah. A little switchy. shabby. Getting pretty lazy, no biking.